Hi there, I'm Professor Jonathan Singer. I'm the Vice Chair of the CAAT Academic Bargaining Team negotiating on behalf of full-time and partial load faculty at Ontario's 24 public colleges. And this is the second of a series of videos on SWFs, what they record, how to read them, and how to identify and correct any errors in your workload assignment. This video will be looking at attributed time for preparation on the SWF and discussing how preparation time is calculated and recorded on the SWF. So as discussed in the first video, the SWF, or standard workload form, includes all aspects of our workload during the assigned periods of workload, and that includes teaching contact hours, class preparation, evaluation and feedback, and complementary functions. This video will be looking at class preparation. The next two videos will be looking at evaluation, feedback, and complementary functions, respectively. Now, the SWF formula provides minimum amounts of time for preparation of each teaching contact hour. So for each hour that you have been assigned to teach students, you are also attributed, based on the formula in the collective agreement, a specific amount of time to prepare that teaching contact hour. And the amount of time that you're given to prepare the teaching contact hour depends upon specific variables. Firstly, have you taught the course before? If you haven't, you get more time to prepare. And when did you last teach the course is also a factor. And the other factor is, are you teaching more than one section of the same course? Now, I should note that preparation formulas for continuous intake courses or field placement courses are unique and subject to their own special preparation factors as identified in the collective agreement. I'm not going to be going into them now. Please consult your workload monitoring group for further guidance and understanding of the special preparation factors. So, if you've never taught the course before, or you haven't taught it since a major revision, that is considered a new prep. And what that means is that you get 1.1 hours to prepare each teaching contact hour as a minimum, or to prepare a week's instruction for a 3-hour section, that would be about 3 hours and 20 minutes as a minimum. If you've taught the course before, but not in the last 3 years, and there hasn't been any major revisions since you last taught it, that would be considered established A. You'd be given or attributed 0.85 preparation hours for every hour that you spend in the classroom. And so for a 3-hour section, you'd be given a minimum of 2.55 hours each week to prepare that 3-hour class as a minimum. If you've taught it in the last 3 years, it would be considered established B, and you'd be given just over half an hour to prepare each of the teaching contact hours, or you'd be attributed 1.8 hours, a little less than 2 hours each week to prepare that week's instruction in a 3-hour section. Now, all three of those rows are for the first section that you're assigned in a class. If you're assigned more than one section, then you are given additional time to prepare the other sections, but you're not given as much time. If you're teaching an additional section of the course, but some students may be in a different program or in a different year, then that would be called a repeat A section, and that section you'd be granted slightly less than half an hour to prepare each teaching contact hour for that section, or 1.35 hours to prepare all the instruction for the 3-hour section weekly. And if you're teaching an additional section of the course, but all the students are in exactly the same program and exactly the same year in both of the sections, then that would be considered repeat B, and you'd be given only slightly more than 20 minutes to prepare each teaching contact hour, or just a shade more than an hour each week to prepare the 3 hours of instruction for that section. Now, all of this is actually recorded on the SWF, and I'm going to proceed to show you how it is recorded and where you can look to find the time that you are attributed for preparation. So this should look familiar. It's the front of the SWF. I do go into greater detail about it in the previous video, but the highlighted section in blue is dealing with preparation. And I'm going to highlight that still further by enlarging. So we're no longer looking at the sections on evaluation, feedback, complementary tasks. We're only looking right now at the teaching contact hours that have been assigned and the preparation hours that have been attributed as a consequence. So if you look at the type, which is to say the left-hand column that's shaded in blue, you can see different types of preparation factors that I've just identified before, specifically N for new, EB for established B, RB, this being a second section of the same course, HTH 306, RB, repeat, the R stands for repeat, and then another course, two sections of it, NUT 205, one of the first section being established B, meaning that it's been taught within the last 3 years by the faculty member, and repeat A for the second section, indicating that it's a second section of a course that's assigned elsewhere on the SWF, but that the students may be in different programs or a different year of study. And each of these provides its own factor. 1.1 prep hours for every teaching hour for a new, 0.6 preparation hours for each teaching contact hour if the type is established B, and for the repeat sections, 0.35 or 0.45, depending on whether the type is repeat B or repeat A, which is to say whether the students are all in the same year and the same section, same program as the other section, or whether there's some variety that you need to prepare for. And when the factor is determined by the type, you have this factor, how many preparation hours are provided per teaching contact hour, then all that needs to happen is for the factor to be multiplied by the teaching contact hours. So for NUR 102 AA, 3 hours of teaching with a factor of 1.1, because it's a new prep, equals 3.3 attributed hours. So this is the number of hours that are being provided for on the SWF. This is the minimum to prepare each week's classes for that section. Moving on, HTH 306 AA has 3 hours in the classroom, multiplied by a factor of 0.6 preparation hours for each teaching contact hour, means that this section, the faculty member is provided a grand total of 1.8 hours each week to prepare the class for that week, the 3 hour class. And the repeat section, the second section of the same prep, gets less time for preparation. It's provided only a shade more than 1 hour per week to prepare that class as the minimum. And I'll mention that the final two sections assigned, NUT 205, sections AA and BB, those are both only two teaching contact hours. So even though the factor is the same, the attributed hours will be reduced. You'll have less time to prepare a 2 hour course than you would have a 3 hour course. Here it's a factor of 0.6. So that factor for established B multiplied by the two teaching contact hours means that this class is being provided a grand total of 1.2 hours to be prepared for that 2 hour class each week. And the second section with a repeat A factor would be provided to multiply the factor by the teaching contact hour and arrive at the attributed hours, less than 1 hour each week for preparation. And again, if you look on the bottom row, you can see that the faculty member is provided a total of 8.25 hours, 8 hours and 15 minutes each week to prepare all of the sections of all of the classes, all of the teaching put together. Now, in many cases, that would not be sufficient, which is why there's a column here for additional attributed hours. These are hours that your manager or supervisor can provide for preparation when the hours that are the minimum hours that are provided by the formula are not necessarily sufficient for the class, for the students, because of other variables. Frequently, these additional attributed hours on your SWF will be zero. But that's not necessarily the case that they should be, because it's quite possible that the amount of attributed hours, the time provided for preparation, is not actually sufficient to do that work. And if it's not sufficient, and a faculty member works over the amount of time that they're provided on their SWF, that likely means that they are doing unpaid overtime. They're doing more work than is being recognized in their workload assignment. It would be preferable to change the workload assignment and make sure that there are enough total hours for preparation to meet the needs of the courses and the students, and to make sure that there is adequate time to prepare these classes, particularly if these classes happen to be online or multimodal of delivery. Variables affecting preparation that the workload monitoring group can look at when deeming whether or not the preparation hours on a SWF are sufficient to actually do the work of preparing the courses that have been assigned could include such variables as the nature or the level of the subject to be taught, including the type and program. It obviously, preparing some courses at a very, very high level may require additional preparation time. Also, perhaps courses of a remedial level may require additional preparation time. The level of teaching and the experience of the teacher and the availability of technical support and other resource assistance. So how much resource assistance is being provided to the teacher? By teacher, we mean professor or instructor. The size and the amenity of the classroom, laboratory, or other teaching or learning facility. So where the teaching is taking place could impact preparation needs, and therefore could impact the amount of time that needs to be provided for preparation on the SWF. Instructional modes, such as online delivery, including requirements for alternate delivery. So things like hybrid teaching, these could all require a level of preparation that cannot be accomplished within the minimum times provided by the formula in the collective agreement, which is to say these are all reasons why additional attributed hours may need to be added to the SWF, which is why there is a column on the SWF precisely to include those additional attributed hours for preparation. Lead time for preparation of new or changed schedules, the availability of the current curriculum, how complete is the course, or how much does the course need to be developed as it goes. Students requiring accommodation can impact workload considerably, but could impact preparation quite specifically. Introduction of new technology, changes to the length of the course, the level of complexity and the rate of change in the curriculum. This is primarily for faculty members who are teaching subjects that tend to change quite a lot and that therefore require additional preparation, especially if they change, let's say, more often than every 3 years. Or require translation of materials. That's also definitely could be a part of preparation that could take additional time that would not normally be reflected on the attributions on the SWF. So that's a bit about preparation. In my next video, we'll be looking at evaluation and feedback factors on the SWF. And in video number 4, we'll be talking about complementary factors on the SWF. And the last video, we'll talk about how to resolve disputes around workload. Thank you very much. Take care. This video is intended only for informational purposes for OPSU CAAT academic faculty members and should not be treated as authoritative advice. Also, it should not be introduced in whole or in part in any dispute resolution proceeding. For authoritative advice on the SWF, please consult your union local or the union-appointed members of your workload monitoring group.